Welcome back. Today, something very interesting has happened on lichess. You'll note we are looking at Zug's profile. Zug, I mean, he's the legend who defeated stock chess or Stockfish in a bullet game to earn the Zug Miracle Trophy, which proudly, oh, wait, it's, where is it? It's supposed to be up here. There's supposed to be a big Z representing his victory over Stockfish. The first of its kind. And not only the first, but a very original trophy. Yeah, you know what? You know what? I just happened to be like cleaning my desktop and stuff. And I just found this. So yeah, I promise I'll return it. But for now, we're gonna take this trophy out for a spin and see if it brings us any good luck. So, that said, let's get started. Let's play some tournaments. Let's see. Go to play tournament. Which one do we want to pick? I would pick 3-2. Oh, in fact, there is a 3-2. This goes for quite a while. Let's pick 5-0. Hourly Blitz Arena. Let's go. So yeah, we're just taking this trophy out for a spin, seeing if it actually confers good luck. Oh, first good luck of the event. Yeah, we get an opponent who goes berserk. So that's promising. Yeah, pardon the wind there. It likes to threaten to tear the door off its hinges. Okay, we'll take one of these and then pin this knight. I'm careful with how I move my mouse because it likes to release the button when I'm not done moving. Oh no. I promise I'll return it, you know. But I just need to see like if it actually confers good luck. So, you know, I hear that it does. It confers you the ability to play just the most ridiculous moves and get the most unpredictable of results. It's like a monkey's paw. And to that end, perhaps I shouldn't have borrowed it. But you know, I just had to find out. I was too curious. Okay, let's do the subtle thing. Yeah, see? It works, guys. The Zug Miracle Trophy works miracles. All right, back to tournament. Here we go. All the trophy. All the trophy. Have to see if we can get that to look a little bit nicer in the overlay. Yeah, it's not the same as having it in your actual trophy case. Here, let me put it down here, just so it's more prominently placed. Right. I don't suppose this guy. No, this guy's not going to go berserk. All right, let's do the Petrov. Are we going to see a Cochrane Gambit? Nope. Let's play d5. All right, and we're off to the races. And defend the pawn. And just continue development. Yeah, it's just a gambit, you know. An easily recouped gambit. So we'll take the pawn back and play f5 at our leisure. Maybe even get the bishop pair. Perfect. Yeah, so f5 comes next. There we go. And now the center's ours. And look, now I can just play my knight up to c5 and d3, and it's all beautiful. Maybe even play rook e8 and try to swindle the bishop. Apparently he's got plans too. Alright, so fine, we'll exchange bishops. Threaten to snap this. See what he does about it. I don't know that he can actually defend that. So, yeah. It appears this trophy is bringing lots of good luck today. I'm sure it'll backfire in some future game, but for now, it's looking very good. Alright, so let's take one of these. He takes my knight, I take his queen. Unlike the last opponent, he's probably going to notice that his queen's attacked. Because his rating's over 1600. Alright, my knight's attacked. I guess I better run. Okay, let's lift the rook. Lift it again. Hit this guy. Activate the other rook on the other open file. And, yeah. Piece of cake. What's the right way to... Oh, g5. g5, aiming for g4, and then I double the rooks on the fourth rank, smashing all the pawns. Easy peasy. Alright. He's intending f3, which I will combat with taking his pawn. He plays rook fb1. Yep, as is predicted, then we just go for the second rank instead. If he tries rook b2, we take the rook and play rook d1 check, winning a rook. Alright, so he's wise enough not to fall for that shenanigans. So we'll just double the rooks here. He's going to play rook f1, and then we just win the b pawn. So aren't endgames fun? Maybe I need to pick higher rated opponents. Just so we get... I mean, this player hasn't done anything like tactically mistaken. It's just strategically they've managed to get such an awful position that it can't be saved. Okay, let's see if this works. Oh yeah! It's a Zug miracle. Not really, because he could do that, but I take en passant, and I'm attacking his knight. So, actually it does work. joke's on him. Alright, so, we're not doing too bad. That's two games, two Zug miracles. Too fast, too furious, you know. Or you see rook g3. Okay. I guess we're not seeing rook g3. Well, that was fun. I sense that my next opponent's going to put up a larger fight. In any event, it's good to play some blitz chess and calm the nerves a bit. Just because I haven't played speed chess in quite a while. So, it's good to just make sure the mouse works. And that my hand is able to move it correctly. Yeah. It's got to be among... Oh, okay. This could be a much more challenging game against a 2400. Let's play the Wing Gambit. Okay, and just play d4. Just take the center. There's no bishop g4, so I'll play this. And we'll play that to defend the e-pawn. And castle, leaving open as many options as possible as to how to continue development. I'm divided here as to what next to do. I have tons of options, and that's the problem. So I'm going to attack the b-pawn. So this is going to be like a Smith Mora, except with me giving up a b-pawn instead of a d-pawn. And this applies some pressure on the center while he still hasn't castled. I'm actually curious how this line goes, which is why I'm playing it. Since I have the opportunity to play against a strong player, I want to see what he does. Okay, and now... I don't know, I think I pin this? He plays bishop e7, of course, to break the pin. And so I'm left wondering... what play, if any, do I have here? I suppose I play to try to take or place a rook on the 7th rank. Oh, that's right. So can't I just take this though? I know I'm temporarily down 2 pawns, but that's a very temporary problem. So now I'm down 1 pawn. I've got some active pieces, so this is pretty decent, I think. I'm trying to figure out what to do next here. Like if I play queen f3, he does bishop e7, and there's nothing to follow. I could do knight to c7, knight a6, but that would just encourage him to lift his rook up. Queen f3 is not terrible, though, because then I do get to follow with queen g3. F4 doesn't really do anything. It looks good, but beyond that, it doesn't do much. I think my bishop belongs on this diagonal. Okay. Why not lift a rook? And then put it over here. I mean, obvious cheapo is obvious, but, I don't know, this feels like a decent position. Yes, I'm down a pawn, but I have some attacking chances. I could play like queen h5, h4. Okay, this slows my attack a bit. Still think this is a reasonable way to go. It hits 2 pieces at once. Actually, he doesn't have a really good way to defend both of those. If he plays g6, I just snap the bishop, so I regain my pawn. My queen's pretty well placed. So now what? This is the hard part. I think I want to develop my other rook. Note that there's no back rank mate threat if I'm careful. If I'm careless, stuff can go wrong, but... let's just go back here. There was nothing I could do to stop him from playing like f6 or f5 and getting his bishop to somewhere where it's not a target anymore. Alright. He's intending like bishop f4 or something here. Hate to do this, but making Luft will serve me well in the long run. Alright, so I don't have a mate threat. I'm just going to consolidate in the center. Oh, my queen's trapped. I've got e5. Wait, no, he doesn't have rook c4, though. Otherwise, my queen would be trapped fatally. Here, though, I just have e5. I'm not sure if this tactically works out. You know, it does. I'm okay there. Not sure if it's a good idea, but tactically it's not losing. I think I'll try it. Because every square I go forward, will help me that much more. All right, so let's hit the rook. Incidentally making a mate threat, which he parries instantly. All right. And I don't know. Oh, my knight's attacked. Let's do something about that. Oh, he's got like bishop c4 there. That's unpleasant. All right. I think I can get away with this. Actually, that's really strong if I can. No, I can't get away with it. I'm just losing a pawn because of f4, bishop takes, queen takes, rook e1. I don't have a counter for that. So yeah, this is good for no more than surprise value. I could throw in rook c3 first. Well, I kind of have to here. Trying to bolster this f4 push. He's got queen b8. Oh, but no, I've got rook c8 to follow. I just got exceptionally lucky. Holy moly. Gotta believe in the trophy. With like 40 seconds to go, you know, I'll offer draw. Because I didn't deserve this at all. He's probably pissed. Because I've been playing like a monkey the whole game. I feel bad about it. I mean, I've been playing good moves, but it's just been completely accidental. Yeah, it's just complete coincidence that, like, his only way to defend the rook and still control f4 is with queen b8, and then I happen to have a fork on the back rank, which just works magically. Yeah, okay, he took it. I don't blame him. I don't want him getting pissed. Cause I wasn't doing that for the rating points. I was doing that to see how he'd play it. And I did enough disrespect to my opponent just in the way I handled that game, so. It was a fun game. He was probably quite ticked about how it played out, though. Honestly, he could, I don't know, they say masters can draw at will. I know I'm not a master, not an, even an expert yet, but at the same time, like, I feel like I played pretty well that game. Otherwise, I'd blame him for not playing better. If he wants to win, he's got to earn it. Having a 2400 rating doesn't just give you points. You have to earn the points. All right. Are you going to see bishop g2? That's not bishop g2. Here, let's play d5. That seems to be working for us. Like this whole gambit of pawns, see what happens sort of thing. Seems to work pretty well in blitz. Yeah. I don't know how to make that trophy appear on select pages. But you know, the important thing is that I've got the trophy. Yeah, web development is hard. Especially if you're not a spider. Alright, so... Oh, are we going to see bishop f1? How great would that be? Bishop f1, knight f3, mate. So yeah, that thing I said about like giving up a pawn and see what happens, that worked pretty well this game. I don't know what you think, but I think that worked pretty well. Alright, so we're not going to see Bishop f1. We're just going to see me brutalize this guy. Just take all his stuff. Crush his spirit. And go back. The key to winning these tournaments is to either effectively, swiftly defeat your opponent, or demoralize them to the point where they resign as quickly as possible. Because this isn't a Swiss pairing system, so like this is an arena pairing system. The quicker you finish the games, the more opponents you get. I might be stuck with this opponent for the rest of the event if I can't find some better moves. I can see Bishop d2. Oh, I was gonna do Rook c2 and be all fancy. Just settle for this. Check. Come on, King e1. That's not King e1. Alright, Queen a5 doesn't work. Queen g5 is pretty menacing. He's gonna play Rook f4. And I guess I just take the bishop. Oh, never mind. That worked. I guess you got focused on this bishop being hanging. Alright, one more game. Let's go, go, go. Alyokin, as Zug would put it. Four pawns attack. The most aggressive variation. Alright, let's push, let's push! That's beautiful. I sense that I have a move somewhere here. I don't know exactly what. I know that like my rook's trapped and stuff, but I think the queen is trapped if it takes that. I'm not exactly up to date on my theory. But I think that is a queen trap. So then we just go here and then play like knight c3 and collect the queen. Zug, your trophy has been bringing me good luck. It's, I don't know, it's an absolute monkey's paw. And I was just dusting out my closet doing some spring cleaning and I just happened to find it, you know. So, I promise I'll give it back. Oh, yeah, like I said, a complete monkey's paw. That was a good game. Not really, but that was fun. I totally fell for that. So yeah, I need to learn that four pawns line. Probably when he plays e6, I shouldn't play d6. Probably I shouldn't also talk while playing, because bad things happen. Okay, he's not going berserk. Okay. Let's make him wait it out a little bit there. Let's take one of those, go up here. Take that. Oh, this is disgusting. I should not have played that. Yep. So let's develop this way. All right, so what's this? Oh, that dude? Yeah, that dude's okay at chess. Here, let's just take some squares. Do absolutely nothing in particular. Try to wait this out until the end of the tournament. And then lose the rating points at the end. Right, so not threatening anything at all. Okay, fine. It's gonna be defensive like that. Okay. This looks scary. I probably should not have played this way. Back to b8. Queen d7? That's not queen d7. That's also not queen d7. Alright, so I've got one move here. Would have been nice if he went berserk in response to my going berserk. That's a pretty conventional thing to do. Right. Assume he's going to play, yep, queen there. And now what? What's the plan? He's got to find some way to activate his pieces. Yeah, that works. All right, so how do I get out of this? Do I do king takes? Do I do, I mean, I'm screwed here, but now how do I try to get out of this? King takes, queen f5, king h4. That's worth a try. Alright, so now we spend an eternity here choosing between the two moves. Because there are only 20 seconds left in the tournament, and because my opponent didn't go berserk. Alright, I guess we'll go this way. Alright. Yeah, my king might be in a bit of a fix here. So I could probably safely concede. Yeah, let's concede that. Well played. 25th place. Alright, let's go play some chess with an increment. Yeah, I'll try to play a bit more focused. I haven't touched chess in a while. I'll try to play better moves, though. So, got a 2100 here. Say good luck. Oh, alright. So, let's transpose. I assume he's going to play d5. He plays d5, we transpose into a pan of Botvinnik. That's not a pan of Botvinnik, so instead we'll play, I'm not sure if this has a name. Okay. One of my friends called this the Flying V. I'm not sure how good it is. Let's see. I'm not understanding Zug's question, unfortunately. How do I develop here? Oh no, I just take a5. That's how I get out of this. All right. Have fun with the stupid show or whatever. So, I think this is still okay. The idea that I could play this attacking that, just tying him down a little bit. And if he gets like overzealous with c5, I could just sack my knight on d5, maybe. Probably not, but I have plenty of options here. So he's trying to build pressure on my knight. Don't know how to deal with that. Got rook c1. That just drops the a pawn. I don't know how to progress here. Bishop d3 loses my knight outright, but prevents castling. Rook b1 forces an exchange, and then after said exchange, I don't know any tricks. Let's just develop this way. That way, if c5, I could play queen d3. So now, not sure how to follow. I could sack my knight on d5 if I'm really desperate. Oh no, like everything I have is hanging. Just somewhat frustrating. Get the bishop here with knight b5. Even that doesn't work so well. Just castle. I think that's my best play here. So I still have an outside pawn. But yeah, this is going badly very quickly, because I don't know the Sicilian. So this is going to be a learning experience for me. I did anticipate that, but I thought I was okay. Am I just daft? I mean, perhaps, but I thought this was fine. Okay. I'm not sure. It's really tactically complicated. Okay, so I take this. Clearly, the trophy's having some effect on my play, even now. That's the only explanation I have to offer. C4 complicates even here. Although I think I'd probably just take the queen. So he should probably. I don't know what he should do. It's complicated. If queen b4, I might have queen b3. Although I keep looking at knight c7 and knight d6. Knight c7, then I take. Oh, but then I end up losing my knight after all these exchanges occur. I'm not sure what to do. I boldly ventured for this because he didn't castle. But this looks pretty disgusting. Okay. So I'm thinking queen b3 might be my salvation here. Even though I'm down 2 pawns. If he exchanges queens, I'm in the clear. If he doesn't, I still have some counterplay. And it's more complicated than that, I think. I did consider that, but I don't think that if I played that check, I don't think he would respond that way. Okay. Oops, that would hang my queen. Probably not what I'm looking forward to doing here. Right. So I wonder. Oh, I think I'm okay. Bishop e2 would have been better than what I played. For so many reasons. I'm losing a pawn. That's why I had to play bishop e2 earlier. Yeah, this is pretty sad. That knight is too strong since all the pawns are on one side of the board. Let's pin that down. F4 should be played. Oh, actually, yeah, his move is even stronger than F4. So I have to blockade from in front, which is unpleasant. He's going to play H5. I guess he's not playing H5 right away. He does eventually get to play it. There might be some kind of stalemate trick here. Oh, nice. No, I completely forgot about that. My mistake. Yeah, I can concede that. Alright, that was well played. So, yeah, let's take a look in the analysis board. Oh, this wasn't a Sicilian. This was a Caro. C5 is... I thought C5 was playable. Evidently, just given the way the game played out, that was a terrible idea. Let's hit bishop takes C6 after knight C6. So, back... I mean, this entire... Let me put Stockfish on this. But, no, my knee-jerk reaction to this entire opening is that after C5, I was, struggling to keep afloat the entire time. And at no point was this better for me. That's my evaluation. We'll see if I'm right. It's like here you're suggesting, like, knight e3, king e7, knight takes bishop, knight takes queen, knight takes queen, knight takes knight. This endgame is lost, so I avoided it. Okay, apparently what I played is a blunder, though, and the best move is knight to c7. Yeah, Stockfish, that's great and all that you feel that that's equal. This endgame is lost. There's white's odds of being able to advance this pawn against black's central mass. It's just not going to happen. That's super optimistic to call that equal. I'm sure given some more time, it would come to a different conclusion and realize Yeah, white's down three pawns here. Down two pawn, actually down three entire pawns. Now two pawns plus a just terrible position. So this queen b3 is not actually a blunder. Yes, this is bad, 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 bad. Let's look at this graph. Okay, so the last moment this was okay was before I played c5. So I was spot on with my post-mortem that c5 is basically the move that takes me from advantageous to equal, and then I followed it up with b4, which just made the position terrible. He played a5, and I spent forever thinking here, and I came up with a bad move. I did consider b5, although I thought this was worse for white, and I was correct. But despite this being worse for white, it's white's best move. So when you're in time trouble, you move the rook, but you had bishop takes c6. Probably something not here. Well, there's one shot here. Oh, right. No, I missed that this hits the a8 rook. You're right, I did have this. And this would have been equal. This would have been hell to play out in timed pressure, but yeah, I agree with Stockfish's assessment that this is equal. This bishop's not getting out of the corner. In fact, yeah, king d6, rook c1, rook a4. Why a4? Why not just like rook b6, saying that bishop ain't going nowhere? And then just push all your pawns, and it's just unpleasant. But I did have this. It was my best try. Stockfish wanted knight to e5. Yeah. I wanted knight takes e5 instead of queen b3. Okay. Yeah, so that was my line. This is what Stockfish wanted, was exchanging the knights. I did look at this a little bit. Like, I got this far with it. And I just saw, like, okay, my knight is pinned. Black could castle to get out of this pretty easily. Well, I guess I didn't see that this knight was going to stay attacked. Like, somehow I imagined that there was a bishop here. Or something defending this knight. So I figured, you know, he's just going to castle and it's all going to be okay. I didn't see that this is actually tactically complicated. So yeah, if he takes my knight, I mean, I could take here, he takes, I take, and this is sad. But no, the right way to pursue this is rook fb1, to which black can counter with rook a2. And we'll just leave it there saying I didn't see this. Because this is complicated. But yeah, this would have been my shot to get back into the game. But realistically, what I probably should have done is earlier in the game play better moves. Like, here, I was curious if c5. I mean, I've played other moves here, and it's led to some dreadfully dull games. So this is why I attempted c5. But no, c5 is just not playable. So I should just stick with what I usually do, which is like knight f3. How interesting can Stockfish make this? Okay, a3 does help quite a bit over what I usually do. Usually I just like play bishop d3 and castle and just wait for whatever happens next. But a3 prevents him from putting some pieces on b4, which could be quite annoying. h3, I guess, is a good prophylactic move as well. But yeah, this is not the most exciting or inspiring chess position. There's no pawn imbalances anywhere. Yeah, I don't think c takes d5 is a great idea. It does, preserve white's space advantage, but it takes all the life out of the game if black just does the symmetric capture. So that said, let's play another game. Oh, what comments would those be? Let's play just an open Sicilian. Oh, are we going to get one of the... Yeah, we're going to get... Is this the Sveshnikov? No. Not the Kalashnikov. Not the... I forget what this is. No, I think this is the Sveshnikov. Oh, does my opponent not know this? Dude! Learn your openings! Oh my goodness. That's sad. Well, I wonder if I'm getting a rematch. I suppose not. That was sad. Alright, let's see what we get this time. I mean, clearly you didn't hear my commentary on the previous game. The commentary is that I was getting torn to pieces there, you know? Hello, and good luck. I mean, it certainly was true in the previous game that White had a space advantage. Alright, we're gonna Benoni this. Or Benko this, or whatever it's called. Or I could E6 and Blumenthal it, but no, we're gonna Benko. Just because we can. Alright, and then... Oh. Alright, sure, I'll take one of those. Could play A5, but I just feel like fianchettoing. Like D6 is playable. Whoa, is this theory? Is this theory? If so, that's pretty groovy. So yeah, we're learning theory here, guys. Can I do Queen B4? This looks too groovy. I need to know what's up with this. So the bishop's attacked. If the bishop moves, I'm threatening E4. And if the queen moves there, I've got this. Or even knight BD7, threatening the same thing. It's not really the same, because he plays F4 either way. If he plays F4 here, now I play knight B6. Why do I... Oh. So he's referring to my lichess patron icon, indicating that I'm a supporter of the site. I'll have to answer him about that. Goodness. That wind just never dies down. So what do I do here? I'm kind of tempted to play A5 and then knight B6, and well, let's play knight B6 first and then A5 and then bishop A6. Fair question. I mean, I know you're trying to troll and not get genuine answers. But, you know, that doesn't mean I can't answer your questions regardless. Don't I have knight g4 and bishop d4 here? I'm not sure. No, bishop d4, he's got knight takes d4. I'm just going to push a5, though. Okay, so not sure where my queen belongs after that move. Not sure at all. Here, let's threaten to exchange this bishop off, since other avenues of attack have been closed, and I'm suffering space wise. Okay. This is playable due to temporary tactics. I can get away with this. I actually need to do something like this so I can activate my rook. So. All's well that ends well here. So far, it's looking like this. Oh. Crap. Had to jinx it. Whatever. So, yeah, we get this delightful endgame. Nothing we can't recover from. My opponent's playing really well. It's like he's played this before. Like, almost any D4 player has seen the Benko before. So that's not a big surprise, right? Oh goodness. Well, I guess at least I get this. Time trouble. My nemesis. Either I made it or I'm doing really well here. There's no middle ground. That was my only way to escape mate, as far as I could see in the 11 seconds I had remaining. And I was mistaken. So. Yep, you got me. You got me, buddy. He plays well. I got outplayed that game. Alright. Oh, another Sicilian. Wonderful. So. Let's just use all the pieces. You know, these are the moves, and I'm not sure why. I just play them. Consequently, I'm going to get rolled ever so badly in this position, because I'm not sure what follows from it. I'm just playing moves out of a book. Not that I even have the book in front of me, but I've read a book that says put this piece here, and everything's fine. Queen h5 is my own invention, because I am just confused. Alright. I don't know what to do. Do I play e5 here? That looks terrifying. I could sack my c knight on b5. It doesn't seem to go anywhere. I could play f5. f5 supports a knight moving to e6. I think the book I'm referring to is Modern Chess Openings 13th Edition. I think that mentions this kind of stuff. I could be imagining this, and maybe it was like MCO 14th or 15th or some other Modern Chess Openings book. Not had the patience to read an entire book devoted to an opening. I find endgames much more interesting than openings. So my study is a bit lacking in the opening realm. So he can't even play like knight f6 here to kick my queen. He's probably intending bishop h6, or I don't know. He's intending something to get out of this mess. I can't tell what. But I play bishop takes b5, so that I can land one of my knights on c7, or d6. Which just looks incredibly crushing. Maybe I just got lucky with this. I'm not sure. So let's just step out of that. I'm not sure what he's planning. But this position looks worth sacking a bishop for two pawns. It's probably far stronger than that in actuality. Alright, so he's not taking my bishop, so I'll just take here. And then take on h6. Oh, but that releases his f-pawn. I am clumsy today. I am so clumsy. Oh, I could play knight c5. Thanks to this pin. And hopefully I just don't get mated. There's a real possibility that I might walk into some sort of stupid mating net. If I'm just reckless. I'll take one of those. Take the bishop. I think I'm okay. Even if he plays rook b8. Because I've got b3. Alright. So now I just need to finish development. Knight d5 looks like a great square for the knight. And then we'll just bring up this rook. There's gotta be something useful I can do with all these pieces active. You might even try running his king to the king side or something, because these pieces move swiftly. I don't see how black finishes development. Okay. That's certainly a thought. That's annoying. Okay, I'm gonna make him choose which side he goes to. Okay, I could win this, I think, if I play rook b3. I think I could win that endgame. I'm gonna try it. Okay. Cool. He does agree with me that white is winning that. Or he just doesn't want to play it out. Okay. Let's go back to the Indian openings. Like the King's Indian. Such a simple opening. Once you've spent years studying it. I kid, no. It is in no way simple. So, yeah. I think this is the line I'm used to playing. Oh. Alright, and doesn't exchange, then I have plenty of interesting options here. I've not seen this in a long time. Seems really confusing to me. So the idea is that he wants to play bishop h6. I'm not sure if there's a follow-up idea or not. Like, there's usually more than one idea behind a grandmaster's move. I think here I can get away with knight h5. And then f5 right away. My point is, if he plays g4, I have queen h4. I'm probably mistaken. Oh, this is pretty ugly. Yeah, I have to play this. So, yeah, unfortunately, my bucket of pieces seems to be empty. We don't have the same luxury that we have in Bug House or Crazy House here. So, we just have to make do with what pieces we have. Yeah, this really confuses me. Oh, I can't play c6, which I normally play. C6 here just drops the d-pawn. Yikes. What am I supposed to do here? This is amazing. I guess f5? Seems to be my only way forward. It's a glorious broken z. Oh, is it broken? Or golden Z, I'm sorry, I misread that. Yeah, it is truly a sight to behold. So yeah, we're working on returning that to Zug as soon as we can. But in the interim, I'm testing my luck with it. So far it seems to have brought good luck. Except in cases where I've played such overwhelmingly bad moves that it could not save me. Which is kind of my style, to play bad moves, unfortunately. But I'm working on it. I'm slowly learning how to play good moves. Oh, do I want to take that, or do I just want to develop something? No, I can't leave this pawn in my face like that. I have to take back the square. He's got knight to e6 coming soon. A mess. Okay, so this feigns a threat there. Should be easily parried by, like, queen e1. Although I have knight e3 then. So you might have to play something else to stop this threat. Like knight g5. Knight g5 stops this. And hopefully gives me a tempo to develop. Which is really the goal all along, is just finish my development. And try to attack something. Wait, what? No, that just... That doesn't... That seems ugly. What? I don't understand that. I need to finish my development, otherwise I would just snatch the pawn. Opening up the H file would be not... Would not be the most clever maneuver at this time. So I lift my queen so I could get my rook out of the corner. Yeah, my opponent's not helping me develop. So I'm gonna contradict what I just said last move and do this anyway. because he's going to take my bishop. So that helped me develop. I should have just done knight f3, right? I'm not going to get a second chance to do it. Knight f3, he's got rook h5. I might have to do knight f4. Yeah. Oh, I got rook f3. Here we go. YOLO. And then here we just slowly step forward. Trying not to hang all of our stuff as we do so. Okay. I am so confused as to what's going on. Take one of those, check. All my pieces are getting forked. This is sad. He's gonna take there, or he's gonna take g6. No, he can't take g6. Yeah, so I lose a something, but I'm still active. Piece activity counts for something here. This is sad. I'm just shedding material because I have no time to think. Oh, that loses the game. You know, he could have gone for the mate in one, but... Actually, that's not mate in one, is it? Yeah. It's still pretty good to take ng6. Okay, let's try this again. Another Sicilian. Another open Sicilian. Another, am I going to do this thing again? Let's give it a try. Bishop g7? Okay, so we have transposed into a Nidorf. This is good because I don't know any of the theory of the other stuff that could happen here. Not that I know this either, but at least there's a chance I might learn something here. Okay, so... What am I supposed to do? F5, maybe? Wait, he's got bishop g4. I just let that happen and he didn't do it anything. So I'm going to exchange here before I lose an exchange. What's a privil edge? Is that like the edge of a cutting tool? Okay. My privil edge. Okay, I will have to check my privil edge. Okay, I check here. The edge of my privil looks okay. So I'm keeping that square under control, this square under control. Yeah, I'm not sure what he's going for with this opening. Probably knight to c5 is an objective. I want to develop something and attack something. If I play h4, he just does bishop g4, which kind of ruins my game. So let's play this prophylactic bishop e2. No, I was not the player doing that with Mandarin Monkey. Let's see. Oh, like I said, he's planning this. All right. Well, let's not hang the A pawn. Okay, I forgot though, the E pawn is kind of loose. So I can't just do queen B4 as I had intended. I have to do something more defensive. Is okay, because it's got some offensive point to it as well. Here, we'll stick the bishop there and see if he exchanges knight for bishop. Not in exchanging mood, I see. I don't blame him. Bishop takes, bishop takes. Yeah, well, that's not working at all for me. Fine, we'll go into this. He starts exchanging. I can take on d6 eventually. For example, bishop takes, I could do queen d4. Oh, okay, so I don't get to threaten d6. This is point. But this closes the diagonal to his bishop. So I get. Oh, okay, he's a step ahead of me and a minute faster. He's pretty good. That's why he's 2114 or 2134, and I'm 2016. Because he sees the stuff faster than I do. Know, if you're going to spell American, you should use a capital A. Just saying. Your grammar teacher will tell you such things. So let's develop. No. Yeah, no, I am confused as to what I should be playing here. Because none of my pieces have good squares, and because the kingside pawn push doesn't really get me anywhere. H4 was probably still the way to go there. And even now, it's probably still best. Though less effective than it was earlier. Okay. Oh, hang on. I am in such severe time trouble that I'm just hanging material just for the fun of it. Yeah, no, that's fine. We can concede this now. I wasn't getting too far. He like instantly mashes the rematch button. And since he's the better player, I'm glad to play some more. Though at some point I've got to learn these openings. All right, here we are playing the whatever this was. Grünfeld. Grünfeld. That's what this is. This is my attempt to play a Grünfeld. So we play bishop g7, and then we play c5. And we just try to put pressure on the center. Oh. Wow, you think Trump directly went to London to do that? That's impressive. I just figured you spent the weekend golfing, but what do I know? You must have a pretty well-informed source there. Okay, so I think bishop e3 is more common. Though I'm not sure I understand why. Goodness. Wait, should I do bishop g4 here? I feel like this is something I should do to try to undermine the center. Of course. Well, let me know if he's got any winning lottery numbers he wants to share. Just saying. Let's see. I don't understand this. Like, my opponent is a strong player, but why would he go for this endgame? This endgame looks perfectly fine for black. Yeah, I just play h6 and just mosey or settle in tight and I don't know. Rook d6 is pretty atypical for this structure. Usually you look for some different way to activate your pieces. But here, this seems to do the job quite nicely. So let's just go over there. And ultimately see if we could target some of this stuff. It's tricky here to maintain defense of the knight and of the b7 pawn. But white has been throwing everything at the king side, and so has kind of ignored other sections of the board. You don't think this is an endgame? I guess, yeah, it's a bit premature to call it an endgame. I just anticipate that pieces will get exchanged soon. But yeah, there's a lot of pieces on the board. It's probably premature for me to call this an endgame. So yeah, I'm not sure how to play this. I think I want my rook on the open file. Yeah, well, it's your opponent's fault for agreeing to a game where the time control allows either player to push the other player over the clock. Here, I'm playing with a 2-second increment, so if either player loses on time, it's not your... it's neither player's... it's not the winning player's fault, is what I'm trying to say. So, f5 is a thing here. F5 is even more of a thing after that move. Okay. I think I'm lost. It's not entirely clear. Let's try to make it even unclearer. Oh, shoot. I forgot he's got rook b2. Oh. Apparently he wanted to go into this, so we're going here. Oh, that makes a lot of sense, though. He's completely winning this. This is bad. Here, let's try to step out of the tactics, but there's just too many. Right. So I have to keep the rooks on the board, which means I have to give up this pawn. Give them all these passed pawns that are connected and try to do something absurd here. There's no way this works. If d7, I'm just dead. There's like nothing. Oh, that even seals the nail in the coffin even tighter. Yeah, I can resign that. Yeah, there's no stopping him for playing rook e8 and then pawn e7. Well, I don't know. Somehow it's just dead lost. Even if there's no immediate forcing continuation that just crushes, he is eventually winning that. Okay. Yeah, I was curious why he just keeps hitting the rematch button. I just keep slowing down more and more just to like give him a hint that, it'd be nice if we were to take a break from some of this and I got a chance to play somebody I had a chance against. All right, so we're gonna play my old shenanigans I did against the Nidorf, which is just fianchetto. Just bring the knight back. No book recommends this. It's probably not best and probably not that great. But it gets me a position that I'm capable of playing without getting killed in the opening, which is saying a lot more than, say, most of the games that we just observed. So yeah, I've got something in this position. Even if it's a really uninspiring position and my bishop's blocked by the pawn, I can at least complete my development, and I don't know what to do after that, but think I can even get away with knight h4. Oh, but he just plays g6. This is pathetic. Oh, or he exchanges for I don't know why. To make things interesting. But yeah, he's got like knight d7 to c5 or f6, and white really doesn't have anything in particular here other than just vague threats. Yeah, no, that sound is just high-speed winds moving outside the window, causing it to vibrate. There's nothing I can do about that. Other than, like, replace the entire window, which is a mess. Also, yeah, there is the alpaca. Just picked him up yesterday. He enjoys chewing on all the furniture. But that doesn't have anything to do with the noise. Just random piece of trivia. Thought you'd want to know. Okay, so having isolated pawns is not the greatest thing ever, but having backward pawns is also pretty bad. So I'm picking the isolated pawn. Or choosing to have an isolated pawn. The idea of playing rook ac1 and rook fd1 and hitting this. He preemptively defends it. So maybe I'll play my rook to b1 instead of c1. Or maybe I'll preemptively just stick my bishop here. The bishop's supposed to go outside the pawn or pawn chain anyway. Oh, blast it. He's got this nasty fork on f4. That really sucks. Just when I thought I might have had something here. You know what? I'm just gonna play f4. If he does knight takes, I'll just sack and exchange, because I am bored. I can't put up with that. I'm just really flustered with the fact that he had that and I didn't see it coming. So, gonna try to play this my way. Get some compensation for the exchange. Bishop's not that much worse than a rook in this type of structure. But But also, I just don't want to get repeatedly stabbed with that knight. Due to my just weakened king. And a queen and a knight are really strong against a fragmented king side. So, so I'm making up excuses for sacking the exchange for fun reasons. Oh, I'm dropping this pawn. We'll check that out. Okay, my bishop's hanging. Let's find a different way to hang it. Oh, shoot, I don't even get any stuff here. His queen defends the diagonal. Yeah, never mind. Whatever. That was a game. Fun Slayer has slain all the fun. Alright, we'll tell him thanks for the games. So yeah. Important to keep your... Well, let's actually take a look at this. My play is pretty disgusting. Oh yeah, no, never mind. This isn't anything near inspiring. Like, knight h4 is horrendous. The white's position doesn't really offer much here anyway. Really, white needs to, like, play, I don't know, knight d5 and c3 and somehow reroute this other knight to f5 somehow. Like, knight d2, f1, e3, f5. It's just very slow. Black gets a lot of counterplay while white's shuffling pieces around, so it doesn't work very well. So this is why you don't play, like, literally what I played. There's no need for me to take on f6 so in such a hurry. I'm not sure why I did that. Should have just kept the pressure here. And that would have even offered me the opportunity to play knight h4 in the game. Like, if I just played bishop there, castle, I don't know, queen c7 or something. Whatever he plays, I still have this ability to move my knight and not get wrecked on h4. So exchanging f6 is pretty bad. This opening was just a series of mistakes after mistakes after mistakes that just spiraled into something glorious. Yeah. Alright, let's see if we can do better. Got a Sicilian. Alright, we're gonna see, yep, we see another Nidorf. Everybody plays the Nidorf. I'm sure if I play against it enough, I'll eventually learn why it is that some of these things work. I think, forget if white's supposed to play bishop h4. No, actually, there's two moves here. They're both okay. Bishop h4 is fine. Taking on f6 is also fine. I think castles is playable. I can't do bishop c4 with the queen there. Now can I? So we'll just push this. Alright, so... I must have done something right, because he played that pretty quickly. Screw it. We're gonna sack. Here we go. YOLO. Oh, this is disgusting. Although it's fun, so... I wonder. We're gonna learn the Nidorf the hard way. Through experience. Check. Alright. Defend the b2 square. If he does knight takes, and I do pawn takes and bishop takes, bishop takes doesn't quite work so well. So yeah, he can't just liquidate there. So I don't know. Let's just develop this, not get mated with like rook takes and rook a1. Oh yeah, no, this is like the sharpest line of the Nidorf or something, so. All the Nidorf lines are sharp. Basically, I just sacked a piece because I don't know what I'm doing. And after the game, Stockfish is going to tell me why did you do that. And it's going to point out a better piece to sack, so. Yeah, no, Rook takes a2 last move would have allowed some interesting play. Now, with this knight on a5, he can't take on a2. So maybe I just go up? Seems dubious. Also seems fun. Let's try it. So he can't take on a2 with his knight in the way. The only square his knight could really go to and start threatening things would be c4. But I've got that covered. Now I can protect my bishop. Origin my name, I just hit some random keys on a keyboard. You know, it's what anybody does. So do I play f5 here? F5, e takes, g takes, bishop takes, knight takes, g takes. Rook g1. Looks okay. F5, e takes, g takes, bishop g5. I don't know. Let's try it. I'll run out of time if I keep calculating everything. Let's just go look at one variation and play it and hope that we found the right variation. It's one and both and neither. No, but seriously, if I were to say it were like the Nintendo thing, they'd probably come after me and tell me you can't use that name anymore. So, I guess on the books, it's not the Nintendo thing. Although there's an interesting situation intellectual property wise, because Nintendo's unsure of whether or not it has the rights, the IP rights to use said character, which was made in a joint de oh, made in a joint development between Nintendo and Squaresoft. So, I don't want to call a victory, but it seems like he's not coming back. I don't know what's up with this game. I could call it a draw, or I could keep hitting like the plus time button and see if he actually shows up. But no, it seems like he's left. I'd want to play it out. And on the other hand, I think I'm actually maybe winning this. But maybe not. So I guess a draw is a fair outcome. Just is unfortunate that in my last couple streams I've lost like 200 rating points or something. Not quite that many, but you know, what can you do? All right, we'll call it a draw. Take a look. Why does everybody play the Nidorf? That's what I want to know. Why don't I play the Nidorf? Well, the reason I don't is because I don't want to spend, like, I don't know, months studying the theory. All of which could be, like, dismissed if white just plays, like, 2c3. It's just not worth my time to study all that. Yeah, no, I hear you. That was weird that, I'm not sure exactly what happened there. Okay, so toward the end, I actually did get an equal position. Yeah, I didn't think King G7 was the best use of a tempo. Because he needs his rook to defend the king anyway. There's no sense bringing the king, like, toward where the pawn breaks are happening. Yeah. So, how did I mess this up? Let's learn from your mistakes. Knight. Knight DB5 was played. Find a better move for white. Good luck. Here, I'll show you a better move. Knight takes knight. Oh, it was okay. Queen takes. Oh, this looks boring. How can I make this interesting earlier? Next. Bishop C4 was played. Find a better move for white. A3. Yeah. Oh yeah. I'm doing far better with these puzzles than with, like, the actual tactics trainer stuff. I guess that means my hindsight is 20/20. What can you do? Alright, so let's see if we can at least get back to 2000. If not, no big deal. If we could, that'd be kind of nice. Am I at 2000? I don't think so. So I was like at 1990. I'm in 1988. We'll see if we can get back to 2000. If not, that's okay. Alright, E4. Oh, alright. So what opening are we getting today? Whatever this thing is called. I've played this before. I sense that I'm not playing this correctly. I have flubbed this in a tournament game, and it was pretty embarrassing. I lost the game in, like, or I got a severe material deficit in the first 15 moves, I think. So since then, I don't know. I guess I haven't really, well, after the game I studied it, but I have not reviewed it recently. So I've probably since forgotten the theory and would probably fall for the same shenanigans again. I don't want to take this, but I don't seem to have much choice in the matter. And now E5 is loose. I don't see a way to avoid losing the pawn. Yeah, that pawn looks very lost to me. At least I get piece activity for it. Oh, I forgot. He just takes here. Great. Let's just defend the pawn. That was the plan all along, was to save that pawn. And we succeeded. Or, I don't know. We're doing something productive here. It's feeling like I'm probably not going to make it back to 2000. Let's see if we can make it to 1950. That's the new goal. Yes, I am aware that my rating is over 1950 at the moment. That way, if we're at 1950, then next time we'll catch our opponents off guard if we actually win a game. So that's the plan. Okay, so I don't understand that. That's just a wasted tempo, basically. F5 seems to, well, so many things I could do here. And we're going to push. I could have gotten 2000 last game. Just need to just wallop all the 2100s and 2200s. And, you know, that's how you get 2000. Right. That too. You don't want to, like, give up on your goals that quickly. Okay, defend the knight. See, he's just, like, reacting to my moves in the same way that I'm reacting to his moves. Neither of us is really doing anything particularly constructive at the moment. I'm trying to, but I'm not making very much progress toward any single constructive goal. Well, I mean, yes, I've connected my rooks, I've advanced on the king side, created some pressure, and scared him into moving back. But other than scaring him into running away, I haven't achieved anything constructive here. Oh, that's defended, actually. I don't need to push it. So, threatening bishop c5. So, ooh, now what? It's not a whole lot I can do. I don't even know if I want to stop bishop c5. Doesn't look constructive. Let's get my knight off of the edge of the board. Alright, and then activate the rook. I mean, he's playing moves that are trying to, like, get me to react to what he's doing. Okay, that actually does kind of force me to react. But I'm not sure that that's in his favor to play that. Actually, it doesn't even force me to do anything. I can just, like, bring my king up and then bring my rook over here. And his king is starting to feel the heat. Yes, let's do that. Important note, if queen h5, knight takes queen. That makes this entire setup possible. Along with viewers like you. Okay, so he's going to try to put some pressure on the g file. Okay, he's actually got something interesting here. I'll just put all the rooks on the G file. So, in this wide open position, oh. Never mind for on the thing I was about to say on bishop versus knight. Oh, I'm also in severe time trouble. I'm trying to explain everything. I've fallen for the most classic trap of them all. So, question. Can I win this endgame if we liquidate all the pieces? Probably do my owing to my superior king placement. So I'm going to attempt to liquidate all the heavy pieces and use my king. Shit. This gets complicated. This is what happens when you try to do strategic things and you have no time on your clock. I think I'm still fine, but this is very scary. A7 is defended, by the way. So he's probably going to play rook e1. I don't have a response planned. I'm gonna do queen f2 because I don't see like what's going on. This is forced, I think. And I think that's forced. Okay. Might work out after all. I think he screwed up. I think he screwed up. There we go. Move 40. That's good timing. Yeah, getting that time back on the clock did help. So yeah, like I said, trying to do strategic things in time trouble doesn't quite work out. You just have to like play moves and try to hang in there. So yeah, just when we hit time control. All right, so we're getting closer. Let's see if we can maybe get up to 2,000. Now, that was planned a whole time, guys. But that's what happens if you go pawn snatching. You have to be careful not to snatch too many pawns when you're ahead. All right. Are we seeing a caro? This looks like a caro to me. I appear to have screwed up already. Isn't that wonderful? Whatever. It's just a bishop. Didn't need it. My position will be just fine without the bishop. Oh, was there actually a legitimate sack there? Somewhere? Also, why didn't I play e5? I mean, the reason I didn't is because I'm just not paying attention anymore, because I've been playing a lot of games here and having a lot of fun and just really distracted. But yeah. The cool thing, though, is that, like, because he's gotten such a overwhelming position, he's starting to play moves that don't make any sense. This kind of gives me a free hand to start attacking. So, you know, this bishop being trapped by that pawn means that it's going to take some effort for him to untangle. So I can just, like, I don't know. Move these pieces forward and see what happens. Just like bring the queen out here. Start. Pretend I'm playing like a stonewall attack. Just with an extra piece or two. What? This is really slow. I mean, I just play c3 trapping the bishop. But I don't even want to do that. My position's so nice. Much rather play knight d6 and just check you and check. No, that's not mate. Yeah, it is. It's actually mate. Because if he does pawn takes, the bishop doesn't cover f8 because my knight's in the way. So, yeah, this is the move I want to play. And threatening that. Then this. My bishop already covers d8. You kind of have to, like, play queen c7. But this is still hideous for black. I don't understand. Now I play like c4, knight b6 gets played. So, maybe I blew it. Maybe in all that excitement, I messed up. Huh. I mean, this pressure is not going away anytime soon. Here, let's get him to move the knight back. Because if he goes to e7, then I have my mate thing again. So he's got to go back that way. Then I can kick this bishop to go back to a5. And then I'm out of kicking moves. I mean, I want to activate the rook with tempo. I just don't see a way to do it. Okay, let's just start sacking stuff. So the idea is just to play rook f1, no matter what it costs to do so. The bishop d8, I looked at it, and there's just nothing. Oh, bishop d8, and then queen f7, knight e8. Yeah, bishop d8 just wins on the spot. You know, this is a rated game, though, so it'd be kind of cheating for me to do that. Bishop d8 probably no longer wins on the spot. I don't know. It's complicated. Bishop d8, queen takes, queen check, king somewhere. Knight there, queen defends stuff. Yeah, there's no back rank anymore. My whole point of doing this was that I could follow with rook f1. And it seems like black should not be able to survive this in theory. In practice, perhaps, but in theory, just all of black's pieces being on the queen's side, except for the king and the queen here. There's something is wrong with chess if black, in theory, can survive this. In practice, I might screw this up, but this is probably the right idea. Check. Check. And we're threatening mate a couple different. There we go. Stylish mate. Nice. And yeah, no rematch. So guys, let's hover over the rating. 2005, we made it. Barely. Should we look at this one? This is entertaining. This is extremely entertaining in terms of a blitz game. No, I think you're absolutely right that just bishop d8 is flat out crushing here. Apparently queen f4 was good enough to do the job, but the best move was queen f3, of course. I think the point there is that I don't trap my bishop, but I wanted to trap the bishop so I could sack it on h6. No, what's not right with this move? Is this not just winning? Oh, he doesn't have to take it. Well, silly me. See, my move worked. This move didn't work because he doesn't have to take it. Stockfish has no sense of humor. Absolutely no sense of humor. Yeah, this is all mate in 5. Pretty straightforward, and I mean, yeah. Nothing to be done there. Although I thought that, no, I'm just stupid. I thought queen takes knight would have gotten black out of the mate. I'm just being tired, that's all. So, yeah. 60 average centipawn loss. Let's learn from our mistakes. So F5. What? There's something here. Bishop D3, but then what? Seriously? Is this a real sack? I don't like giving up my center pawn like that. That seems... I mean, Stockfish doesn't like the fantasy variation that much anyway. But bishop d3... I think I goofed up my opening move. I think it's supposed to be bishop e3. I'm not sure why I thought bishop d3 was the move. I think I'm confusing that with the Caro Con. No, not the Caro. Confusing that with some other opening. With the Panov Botvinnik. So I was confusing that with this variation. D5 takes this, this, and then black does something, and at some point white plays bishop d3, maybe even here. Yeah, so this is where I was confusing with this opening versus here. Here bishop d3 is no good. Anyway, next puzzle. Castle was incorrect here. Let's learn from this mistake. Was this the thing where I said e5 is just good? Yeah, but what happens? H6, bishop h4, g5. Oh, I didn't see that. That would have been very fun. Okay, next one. Knight h4. Wow. C3 really that good? No, it couldn't be. Is it C4? C4, surely with the idea that black moves this knight somewhere and this bishop's trapped. Need to play more games, you know. Alright, C4 was played. Is the idea here I'm supposed to play A3. A3, H6, bishop C1 takes. The key point here is that if bishop A5, then what? I mean, then we get sadness for black. Where white is just crushing black. It's not even a contest here anymore, because the knights control everything. So black just voluntarily offers the bishop. Next one is knight b6. Learning from a3, which is a mistake. Oh, is this the thing where we said bishop? No, this wasn't bishop d8. Bishop d8's wrong, guys. This is the one where I play queen f4, and it says queen f3 is better because you don't lose a bishop. So black erred, and I should have just activated my queen this whole time. Cool. So, yeah, I think a lot of learning was achieved today. Bishop d8 is excellent for style points, it just doesn't work. Anyhow, yeah, playing with this Zug trophy has led to some very interesting results. I promise to return it soon, but I appreciate the opportunity to take it for a spin. So, really what I need to do is take one quick look at Zug's page, and we need to commemorate once more his game where he triumphed over Stockfish. Thus earning the Zug Miracle Trophy. So E4. So yeah, for whatever reason, during that time, Stockfish was pretty hooked on the French defense. And so Zug, obviously being a national master, knows how to generate attacks that have far-reaching consequences that could be over Stockfish's search horizon. And so he sacks the bishop. Stockfish declines to take the bishop because, well, you just get mated right away if you do take it. But even if you don't, you're just getting smashed. So yeah, Zug is still offering. He earlier offered the bishop. He's now offering the knight, and we got the check and mate in four, mate in five, mate in four, mate in three, mate in five, mate in four, mate in three, mate in three, mate in two, mate in one, and there you go. So, very well played game. Showing the power of taking advantage of an engine's search horizon while at least expecting that. So, well done, Zug. So, hope everybody's enjoyed. Thanks for watching. And hope to see you next time. Take care. Have a good night.